so this shoulder warm-up is like my favorite and my least favorite at the same time. Really opens up everything in your chest, because a lot of us are like this on our phones, like, or on our computers. I'm always like crouched over my computer, so this just opens everything up. But it's so difficult to keep your lower back and your elbows and like your forearms and everything on the wall, and then your head, so you're not coming up, you're not like going like this at all, everything's just flat. So 90 degrees, and you're gonna go up as high as you can. And it really hits your middle upper back. Ugh. And then just getting a little ab work in before the workout. I love doing abs first, like he was making me do that first, and he's not here today. But I love it because it makes my whole body warm for the whole exercise versus just like doing the workout and then doing abs after. Like, abs are incorporated in everything. So doing some just basic leg lifts. Trying to keep the arms here, so it's just focusing here. Legs in helps your lower back relax it out. I love starting with shoulder press, whether it's barbell or standing or just seated shoulder press. So I'm gonna do seated today because I have a hat and I can't do barbell because it'll just take that out. I usually start with a lightweight warm up. So I'll do about 12 to 15 with lighter weight to warm up, and then I'll get into my working sets immediately after. Next, I'm doing lateral raises with 10 pounds, and I'm trying to get to 15 for the lateral raises, and then no rest immediately after, supersetting with upright rows with the easy bar. Doing 10 reps of those, so it's gonna be 15, 10, 15, 10, 15, 10, 15. Chair right behind you, so when you're done, you just sit. Shoulders, and you're like crouched over the computer a lot of the day, like I am, definitely have to like open up and make sure that like your chest is open. That's why I do those things, the arm to wall things, and then you can do band openers, you can do openers like this, but just getting all this open before you start working out is really important, sometimes even halfway through. It's like cardio and shoulder workout at the same time. And it's also like a lat workout. You're pulling and you're focusing on pulling, leading with your elbows when you're pulling down. You're not trying to like pull with your arms, more so trying to pull with like your back. It's kind of like a lat pull down. So we're doing this, supersetted with your face pulls. And like, I'm gonna do this for 30 seconds as hard as I can. So you need a good song. So when the beat drops, it's on SoundCloud.
hope you guys enjoyed this slightly raw workout. I wanted to keep it raw. I haven't done a raw workout in a while, and then I gave you guys some tips in between. So let's go ahead and get into my reverse diet update. It's been about 5 weeks since I stopped my cut, so let's hear how it's gone.
Creepy in the background.
I just lurked right
here. Everyone be like, who is the person?
Cover your face.
It's a mirror.
It's just a mirror. Okay. All right, guys, you are seeing my physique update from yesterday morning. So when I went to Ohio, I kind of didn't track. Like, what I'm trying to do for this reverse diet is eat around my calories that I set it at, like, after I decided to end the cut. So I haven't upped my calories yet, but what I've been doing is trying to kind of eat around those calories that I knew that I was gonna be going to both Ohio and then I was home. I did my best to, like, basically kind of, like I've been doing, like you saw in my last full day of eating video, I basically track half the day and then I know how many calories I have left and I'll kind of just eat whatever I think fits that. But it's really helpful for me mentally to have some structure and some freedom with this, because otherwise if you get too restricted and you're trying to reverse diet and you're really, really restricted, the amount of freedom that you have with your food kind of just gets lost in the fact that you're so free and you are not able to kind of stick to something. So what I found works really, really well for me is having like half kind of tracking and then half not, but staying within my range. So I did my best to do that in Ohio. There were two nights where we went out to eat with like the whole entire team, and I probably didn't hit my macros those days. I was really bloated like the whole time. I wasn't drinking enough water at all because I was at an event. I felt kind of crappy, and then I came home, I slept a lot. I am kind of sick right now, but I got to like rest and recover a lot, and I'm just back down to my normal weight that I've been this whole entire time. So really, really good. So what I'm gonna do now that I've kind of came back from that trip that I was just like, I wanna make sure that I'm not upping my calories and then overeating again because I'm like on this trip. So now that I've like gotten that out of the way, I'm not doing the same thing as I did last year, but now that I've gotten out of the way, I'm gonna just go ahead and up my calories by, I haven't figured it out yet, by about 10 carbs and about 3 grams of fat or so. And I've already upped my fat about 3 to 5 grams since I stopped my cut. And I feel really good with this. I feel like I can just kind of go about my day normally and eat intuitively. I'm not in this place where I'm like trying to make sure every single gram is tracked. I'm not in this place where I'm trying to restrict how many like carbs I eat during the day. I'm just kind of eating what feels great for me, and it's just really nice. I'm like at this point where it just feels so good, and I feel good about how I look. I feel good about how I feel aside from this little cold that I got, but it's going away. I'm taking my vitamins and stuff. That is the update for you guys, and update for what I'm going to be doing with my YouTube channel soon. I kind of had that talk with you guys in the last video, and I super appreciate all of like the really amazing comments in the comment section. I tried to respond back to almost every single one of you and at least like your comments, so I super appreciate it. And then just being able to go through this kind of like change with me. So what I'm going to be doing is, I think, let me know if you think this is a good idea. I don't think there's a right answer for this, but maybe make a different playlist for like business personal development videos, and then keep these fitness focused, reverse diet focused, training focused videos in a different playlist. So like all having it on the same channel, because you know what? I don't really feel like starting a whole new channel. That's not really what I feel like doing. It's just, I don't wanna do it. I don't know, let me know if you guys think that's a good idea. I think I'm gonna do that and start making some like cool shorter videos for you guys on just tips. Life tips, personal development tips, maybe business tips, and just make them shorter and not really vlog style. That's an idea that I have. I haven't decided yet. We're gonna commit to something soon. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.